Good afternoon, everybody. How's everybody doing?
Good.
Good. Great to see you. Today, we're going to be talking about context clues. And before I get into the formal definition of context clues, let's talk about where you can find them or how you can use them. So, have you ever been in a conversation or reading a book and come across a word that you don't know?
Yeah.
Happens to me all the time. So, today we're going to be talking about a new skill we can use to figure out that word by ourselves using our brains. And those are context clues. So context clues are words or phrases that help us understand what an unknown word might mean. Now, do you think you could find context clues just in the sentence that the word is in?
No.
Well, that's the point of the word, context clues. They're found in the surrounding area of the word. So you can find them in the sentence before the word appears, or the sentence after the word appears, and the sentence where it actually appears too. There are lots of types of context clues writers use, but three really common and important ones are synonyms, which is when the context clue means the same thing as the word we're trying to figure out, antonyms, where the context clue means the opposite of the word we're trying to figure out, so what the word isn't, and examples, where we get to see the unknown word in action, and we can figure out what it means through that. All right, so moving on to our examples. Alanis, could you read the first example?
Riley's most striking feature was how altruistic she was. Very kind and unselfish in all of her interactions.
Amazing. All right, so if you didn't notice, the word we're going for is altruistic. And so what keywords or phrases in this sentence do you think are important to understanding what it might mean? Cara.
Kind and unselfish.
Kind and unselfish. Amazing, those are great words. And I would actually argue that there are other words here too that are just as important, because it's not just the words that are important, but the way you say the words. So the fact that we have very kind, it's not just regular kind, it's extremely kind, and feature, which tells us that it's a part of her personality. Now, based on what we know, what kind of context clue do you think this is? Alanis?
A synonym.
Perfect, and why is it a synonym?
Because the mystery word is followed by other adjectives.
Yes, the mystery word is followed by other adjectives, like kind and unselfish. So based on that, what do we think altruistic might mean? Haro?
I think it means someone who's very kind and unselfish.
Perfect, it's pretty straightforward, I'll admit, the first time, but in the other examples, it's a little tricky. So, for the second example, Carl, could I have you read that?
Yep.
Thanks.
When the chorus sang, there was cacophony. The harmonies didn't sound peaceful or pleasant.
Amazing. So the word we're going for here is cacophony. Now, are there any keywords and phrases, and keep in mind also the way they're said, that tell us something about the mystery word? Matt?
Peaceful and pleasant.
Peaceful and pleasant. Great. Anything else? Carl?
Chorus sang,
yes. And the reason that's important is it tells us what kind of noun we're looking at. Because if it's chorus and sang, we might think the cacophony is something to do with sound or music. Now, what kind of context clue is this based on what we know? Alanis.
An antonym.
An antonym. And why is it an antonym?
Because it says didn't sound.
Yeah, didn't is the key word that tips us off to knowing that it's the opposite of something. So we know the cacophony isn't peaceful or pleasant. So, knowing that, what might cacophony mean? Matt.
Maybe something that's dissonant, just doesn't really sound great.
Yeah, that's exactly what cacophony is. So the chorus sounds kind of bad. All right, for the final example, Matt, could you read this one?
Sure.
Thanks.
Riley was always known to be prudent. Mm. For instance, when she was planning to visit her grandma, she packed her bag 3 nights before she left and made sure to bring extra clothes just in case it got cold.
Amazing. So, pretty long one, but the word we're looking for right now is prudent. So, what are some keywords and phrases that you think are important to understanding what prudent means? Carl?
Planning?
Yes, planning.
Three nights before.
The
made
whole
thing. Sure.
Made sure.
Extra.
Oh, great one.
And just in case.
Just in case. Amazing. So, what kind of, it's kind of a positive deduction, but what kind of context clue do you think this is? Alanis?
An example.
Yeah, why do we know it's an example?
Because it says, for instance,
Yes, so it says for instance, and through we get to see the mystery word in action. We get to see places where Riley is prudent. So based on the keywords we identified, what do we think maybe prudent means in the context of the sentence? Matt?
Describe someone who plans early, it's very careful, meticulous, like plans for conditions to go wrong.
Yes, someone who's like kind of careful and kind of hesitant, but also just make sure things are right before. All right, that's awesome. All right, so now that we've gone over our different types of context clues, let's learn, let's go over the song that we're going to sing to remember what they are. Let's all learn our context clues.
Context clues.
Let's all learn our context clues. great class. I'll see you tomorrow.